You have a new YouTube channel?
Yes.
Should we talk about
and
that?
And I have a new Floatplane channel.
Oh.
Well, just goes on Floatplane as well. Yeah. Okay. I am ready to talk about how it works on Floatplane. By the way, we're uploading 4K videos to Floatplane now.
Nice.
Okay, so Linus Tech Tips.
So is EPOS.
1 week early access, except when it isn't convenient.
Okay.
Okay, so like if there's an embargoed product, that's gonna go up at the same time.
A show.
Or if a sponsor is like, yeah, no, you're not allowed to release it like early on that one. We want it to go everywhere at once. We're like, okay, I guess. or if for whatever reason we think that this item is time sensitive because, like, I mean, a perfect example would be the kickproof TV. I think we only did like a one-day window on it or something like that because we were deeply concerned that it was going to be yet another one of those stupid situations. Ah, like the 2 terabytes of RAM opening Chrome tabs one, where that video was live on Floatplane actually for about a month. And then someone else, Jonathan Morrison, uploaded a video opening up as many Chrome tabs as he could on his Mac. And then 2 days later, we upload the video doing it to YouTube. And people were like, TLD did it first. It's like, sort of. not really, but sort of. And also, it doesn't matter. Neither of us are the first ones to come up with that idea.
No.
Anyway. So if we think for whatever reason that it's time sensitive, then we might do a shorter window, but we're gonna aim for a week. TechWiki, 1 week. Unless it's time sensitive, like, oh, it's, you know, a rundown of the latest Android OS or something like that, where it's more like news oriented.
So that'll be pretty rare.
That'll be pretty rare on TechWiki, but it'll happen from time to time.
Yeah.
TechLinked, simultaneous release. I think sometimes it hits Floatplane like half an hour earlier. But so we'll upload it to there first, but whoever's done processing basically wins the race. So pressure's on you guys.
Hey!
Channel Super Fun is back.
Yeah.
The first upload in years.
I think so.
Went up today. Well, a week ago on Floatplane. So Channel Super Fun is still gonna have a 1 week window. I'm not going to promise that we would never ever do a simultaneous release or a shorter window, just because if there was some compelling reason, then we might do it. We're targeting a 1 week window just like LTT. And then finally, Short Circuit is the new channel. So what makes Short Circuit different from LTT is the question that a lot of people have asked internally and a lot of our viewers have asked already, seeing the Short Circuit teaser trailer, sort of pilot episode that went up on the Linus Tech Tips channel earlier today as an extra release, and then also the first official Short Circuit video that went up hours later. I had actually intended for those to be like
a few days apart.
So they went up like right after each other, which is sort of not what I had planned, but it's okay. You know what? The team's dealing with it, so I'm leaving it be. So we've had a lot of people ask, well, what exactly is the difference? And the difference is that a lot of the time, LTT has sort of become an unwieldy ship to steer. Well, it has.
Yeah, it's fine.
It has. Yep. There's like, you have a gray hair in your beard.
Yeah, a few of them, actually.
Huh, how about that?
Yeah. It's weird, right?
Like, yeah,
you knew me pre-beard.
I know.
And now the beard like, has gray hairs.
Getting gray. Anyway. So LTT.
It has been that long.
Yeah, LTT has become a little bit of a big ship to steer. So when we decide to do a project, we have to tick all these boxes. Like, it has to be important enough to a broad enough slice of the community.
Okay.
There has to be a title and a thumbnail that is going to keep up the momentum of the channel.
Highly enticing.
You cannot afford. On a 10 million subscriber channel, you cannot afford to upload a week's worth of like niche, you know, videos about some, you know, weird phone with a keyboard on it. That's actually the first video that went up on Short Circuit from some brand nobody's ever heard of when everybody else is uploading Galaxy S20 Ultra videos. That's the kind of thing that gets people to click, you know, not interested, and quickly takes that momentum that you have and destroys it. And when your momentum goes down, it can take months to recover, if you recover at all. LTT took about 7 months to fully recover from the dip that it was going through from January to April of 2019. So we are finally back on track, and I would not do, even no matter how cool I think some product is, I would not compromise the health of the channel and therefore the health of this company in order to make a video about it. That is where Short Circuit comes in. So whether it's something that just doesn't have enough material in it for an LTT, like one of the rules for an LTT video, along with being something enough people are interested in and thumbnail and title, is that there has to be some kind of a learning outcome. So even if it's some, you know, stupid little item that's like a weird $2 adapter that I found on AliExpress, there always has to be some learnable thing in the video. So an example was we did a DIM to M.2 adapter.
Okay.
So I bought that just for an excuse to talk about the different standards that exist for M.2, because some of them run NVMe, some of them actually use the older SATA protocol, and the drives themselves are not interchangeable, and also because I wanted to talk about buying weird adapters on sites like eBay and AliExpress,
okay. Yeah.
And then being disappointed because they don't work exactly the way that you expected them to.
Yeah.
Just looking at that product listing, if I wasn't a really savvy shopper, and I sometimes I play the dummy a little bit in the video, I knew exactly what I was buying, guys. But if I were a non-savvy shopper looking at that product, it would have looked like I installed this in a memory slot, and then I was able to add an extra SSD to my system
like that.
But that's not how it works. A memory interface is designed to have direct access to the DRAM dies that are on the module. It's not designed to interface with a controller, which is how any drive, whether it's NVMe, SATA SSD, SATA hard drive, that's how that's designed to be accessed.
And there was, before that video went out, there was genuinely like FACO, oh man, I can get like so much more RAM by doing this images going on the internet.
Which, dumb.
I'm sure were just meant to be trollsy fun, but probably convinced a couple people.
So basically, even though there was nothing really to the product, there was supposed to be a learning outcome. And so, Short Circuit doesn't need that. It can be just something we think is cool. We don't have to necessarily do a ton of research and go digging to find all the ins and outs of it. There's no pressure to have the greatest title or thumbnail. It's just gonna be stuff we feel like is cool and we wanna cover, and we're not gonna do as much prep. I have actually re-implemented the time budget system. You remember my time budgets?
Not entirely.
Oh, okay. Well, you never agreed to them anyway.
Are they like point systems?
No, it's just an amount of time. Like I just call it, it's like having a budget in money, but it's in time.
Yeah, that's how point systems work.
Is it? Okay.
In like,
so the time budget for Short Circuit is you've got like 45 minutes of prep as a writer, 30 to 40 minutes to shoot it, and then they've got like 3 hours to
edit. So it's like refined unboxing.
It's basically
where you like know what you're getting into.
It's what Linus Tech Tips used to be.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
you like Google, you bring the product to your desk, you look it up, you make sure you're not going to say anything super
really
off
stupid.
The wall.
Yep. And if you make a mistake, then we just correct it. We've actually already, Lloyd designed a fun little character who's gonna pop in and correct us and stuff. So like,
that's cool, okay.
Yeah, it's just designed to be more casual, more fun. It's what LTT used to be. So back when NCIX Tech Tips was too cumbersome to make enough of them and like it was such a long lead time that we couldn't hit, you know, an embargo with an NCIX Tech Tips video. You only had like a week with the product, and usually I needed a week just to like finish my normal work and like get a script written up, and so we were always late and stuff like that. So LTT became the like quick and dirty, just get it out there channel, and now LTT has sort of become this much more elaborate production, and Short Circuit is just going to be quick and dirty.
Yeah,
and,
cut to the chase, Short Circuit.
Exactly.
Sense.
Exactly. So, James came up with the name for it, actually.
I'm surprised it wasn't taken.
It was kind of taken, but not by anyone relevant. So we just, like, there was, like, some podcast that had, like, 4 episodes from 9 months ago, and they hadn't uploaded anything since then. They had, like, 9 subscribers or something. Like, it was, like, it's fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, it already has 100,000 subs, right?
Yes. So, it is the first channel that we've ever started that had 100,000 subscribers before we uploaded a video.
That exact statement right there, I want to lean on and utilize, and is the actual reason why I brought this up. I'm happy you're able to announce your channels and everything.
Oh, okay, so there's an ulterior motive.
Yes.
Okay, does it have anything to do with you bailing on me tomorrow?
I don't want to, well, I'll figure it out. I want you to build a computer case.
Are we going
to
figure it out, Luke?
I want you to build a computer case.
Are we
going to
figure it out? Because it's Valentine's Day.
Out of play buttons.
Out of play buttons.
That you get from channels that you don't upload content to. So, I was working with Jono on this. I came up with a base idea and then we grew it. So, we're thinking, if you name the channels, like right side panel one, right side panel two.
Oh, Lord.
Etc. And then get enough people to subscribe to them. You could build a case out of play buttons.
We could. The case the community built. I kind of like it.
It would be awesome. It would actually be so cool. I think it's one of my,
oh my goodness,
very few ideas that I come up with that actually end up being pretty sweet.
Yeah, it's better than Pizza Warming PC, that's for sure.
That got a lot of views.
I still want to revisit that concept, it, but like better than what you did.
If a lot of time is taken, it would be awesome.
Would be awesome.
You would need a pretty significant amount.
Well, you just didn't do it the way that I had anticipated at all.
I was given, I think, because it was sitting there as an idea, and then suddenly it was like, okay, you have like 6 hours or something. And I was like, well,
I think I could have done something that made more sense in 6 hours.
Maybe. Got a lot of views, though.
That's true. People were so mad. Like, for over a year, that was like the video that people would point at and be like, this channel's gone to hell. And the stupid thing is they'd post, like this channel's gone to garbage, like that video. And I'd be like, okay, how about something from the last 3 months that's garbage? They'd be like, well, that one was bad enough that it doesn't even matter if you've done only good stuff.
We upload every day, and it worked. Sucked in every other way.
You know what? Two other videos of yours created a ton of community backlash back in the day, but ultimately ended up performing really well.
What?
How to hide your...
Yeah.
Your materials.
Yeah.
Your materials with a lot of skin showing.
How's that doing?
Great. That created...
Was it typed literally like that?
Yeah. That's what we called the video. We went totally non-AdSense safe.
It's actually a little worse than I thought, but yeah quite
2.1
good.
Million views on that one.
Yeah.
And people were so mad. Like, dislike ratio's even fine now. And then... The how-to basics, how to install a video card.
Oh, they hated that.
People were so mad. The like-dislike ratio is great, and there's one comment with a ton of upvotes that's like, I don't really get why people are disliking this video. I needed to install a graphics card, and this was perfect.
Almost like, just 2 million views.
Just a total noob who came in, and like that was exactly what they were looking for. But this is what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Where there's a video we want to make that's a tech, but if we were to upload it to LTT, it just wouldn't meet the community's expectations. And sometimes that's not a quality expectation. It's just an expectation. Like, sorry, this video just like wasn't for you. It was for someone else.
I actually thought that video was like pretty good.
I thought it was fine.
Yeah.
It's got like 1.7 million views now because people do need to know how to install a graphics card. I'm sorry, you already know how, and we'll upload it somewhere else next time, but yeah, so that's kind of the update over here. So
just while we're talking about like videos that work unexpectedly well or poorly, Screen Melter prank.
I know.
Literally took probably half an hour from hey, I could do this to like pushing footage onto the whatever we used at that point in time. I think it was a server. And 8.6 million views.
Yep. Like, that's one of our top performing videos of all time as Linus Media Group is the melting screen prank.
Which is just soul crushing.
Poor Taryn. Look how young you are.
Yeah.
Wow. Look how young you look.
No,
you're like a
baby. There. Yeah.
Like a wee baby.
With the Zelda Breath of the Wild concept image as my background.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Wow. Star Citizen poster in the background.
Oh yeah, how'd that work out for you? Well, one of those ended up being a success.
Yeah.
Squadron 41, anyone?
Oh boy.
42? Whatever squadron 42. It is.
Who knows?
It's a theoretical.
It's over now.
Theoretical squadron.
Well, not really, to be honest. Anyways, we can move forward.
Zach K, this channel's gone to garbage. I know, right? We're just gonna make a new one. The new one's gonna rise up from the ashes. All right, we got.
You should let me come back, and I'll do Pizza Heater version 2, and everyone will be so hyped because they'll be like, "Oh my god, he took all this time to do it properly." And then it'll just be cardboard again, and just ruin it.
It's like, well, what did you think I was working on? You know, I wasn't getting a metalworker's apprenticeship. I was building a video streaming site. It's not. I still don't know how to do this stuff.
Actually, work on computers less now. This is probably worse.